In 1864, the Confederacy wanted to use the submarine HL Hunley to sink the USS Housatonic, a Union ship off the coast of Charleston, South Carolina. The Hunley had 135 pounds of black powder attached just a few feet off of its bow. But when it set off its charge, the blast wave from the charge transmitted through the hull of the ship and into the crew compartment, causing fatal lung and brain injuries to the crew inside.
Three, two, one.
The Hunley is the first successful combat submarine because it was the first submarine ever to actually sink an enemy ship during combat. The Hunley's weapon was a black powder torpedo. It was 135 pounds of black powder, which is about the size of a keg, and it was attached to a long spar that was on the bow of the Hunley. The Hunley attacked with its torpedo by approaching the side of an enemy ship. It, using the spar, it jabbed the torpedo into the side of the enemy hull and then triggered the blast. Their spar was only 16 feet long, so they were actually very close to the 135 pound charge. The Housatonic was the Hunley's target. It was hit by its torpedo and it destroyed most of the stern of the vessel. The entire ship sank within about 5 minutes. For almost 150 years, nobody actually knew what happened to the Hunley after it set off its charge. It was lost to the ocean. And then in 1995, it was found, and in the year 2000, it was raised. Since then, it's been under conservation by the archaeologists at Clemson University. When the Hunley was recovered, she was found to be in surprisingly good condition. The condition of the ship suggests that there was no damage from the actual blast itself, and the conning towers and the bilge pump suggest that the crew didn't take action to escape. My research indicates that the crew of the Hunley actually died from the effects of their own torpedo. I concluded that blast injury killed the crew after doing a series of research experiments using scale model, the CSS Tiny. I used this model for experiments both here at the Duke Reclaimed Water Pond and in a test site off campus.
Three,
with live explosives.
Two, one. That was beautiful.
The inside of the sub had pressure gauges in addition to the pressure gauges outside the sub, and we showed that the blast forces propagated through the hull into the crew compartment. So the types of injuries from the crew of the Hunley would have actually been completely different from what we would expect from people in a Humvee hitting an IED. In that case, you're concerned with something called underbody blast, which means there are shrapnel effects and effects from the damage to the vehicle that cause broken bones and other injuries. Whereas with the crew of the Hunley, there was no shrapnel. It was just the blast wave itself that propagated into the vessel. So their injuries would have been purely in the soft tissues, in the lungs and in the brain. And that's actually really consistent with what the archaeologists from Clemson found, meaning that there were no broken bones. Fatal blast traumas occur because the blast wave hits the human body. As it hits a gas-containing space like the lungs, it slows down, and that is what causes trauma to those organs. It's also very likely that these men would have experienced traumatic brain injuries.